Adding narration and sound will make just about any video better. Here's how to do it in Adobe Premiere Elements version 13. What I've got here is just a couple clips of me showing somebody how to sweat pipes together by cutting, cleaning, dry fitting, and soldering everything together. So what I don't have here is I don't have a narration track and I don't have any cool sound on this video. So let's go ahead and add some narration. So the first thing you want to do is bring up our narration tool. And before I do that, let's make a couple double checks here. Let's go to our edit preferences and go to the audio hardware and make sure our settings actually have our microphone turned on. Now that we have that, let's go back to our narration tool. Sometimes it doesn't automatically select that microphone when you get into this narration tool. Also, notice how we can see the VU meter here, and this is up into the red. This might be a little bit too high. We can always dance this down a little bit to increase the microphone sensitivity. All right, so what typically, I don't know how most people are, but sometimes it's very hard for me to record audio, as you're probably watching me stumble through the words right now. So what I've got is this very small script that I've written for this clip that at every segment, I've got something to say, and I've spent a few minutes getting this text down to something very concise. So when I say something, I have meaningful words coming out of my mouth. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag this over my second monitor. That way, when I start recording the audio, I can just simply read that at key points. So let me go ahead and start this, and it's going to pause for a few seconds, and then it will actually begin. So what it's going to do is it's actually going to play the video, and I can read the audio track right over the top of it. Sweating copper pipes is easy. Here's how. First, cut the pipes to length using a hacksaw or pipe cutter. Make sure to cut the pipe length longer for insertion into the fitting. Next, you gotta get your pipes cleaned. Get some sandpaper and scuff the surfaces of the pipe and the fitting. Step 3, add flux to the pipe and fitting, then dry fit everything together. Get the joint good and hot with solder so it flows. Oops, I messed that one up. Actually, I did that intentionally to show you how to make some fixes. So let's hit stop. Let us, and notice how it added the narration track for us. Let's drag this back to the port where I screwed up. And let's go back to our audio or our narration tool and just play this again. So I'm gonna hit record and just read the last sentence. Get the joint hot until the solder flows freely. Solder flows where the heat is, so it will automatically find its way into the gaps. That's it, job done. Now notice how it put the narration actually where the cursor was. If I were really smart, I would have just paged up to get to the very beginning of that track, and I would have recorded my sound there. But no problem. All we'll do here is just grab our narration and drag it over. So let's go ahead and play this thing and see what it sounds like. So let me move my cursor over and crank up my speakers. Sweating copper pipes is easy. Here's how. First, cut the pipes to length using a hacksaw or pipe cutter. Make sure to cut the pipe length longer for insertion. All right,
so there's our audio track. Now, there's a few things we can do with it. If you don't like the volume of the narration track, if you don't like some of the noise that might be in there, there are tools in Premiere Elements that allow you to fix that. There's an adjustments tab. Sorry, after you pick the volume of the narration track, you can adjust the levels. You can adjust balance, treble, bass, all that kind of good stuff. And there's even some effects that you can add to it for adding, if I can find it, well, I'm not even going to mess with it right now, audio effects for changing volume, filling channels from left to right, dynamics, all that kind of good stuff. There's a tool that you can get from the web for free. It's called Audacity. That's my personal favorite, and that's what I'm going to use to edit everything. Let's go ahead and save this, and I'm going to bring that narration underbar 4.wav into Audacity. So this tool here allows you to do all kinds of neat audio editing. So let's just go ahead and open up narration 4. And obviously I've tried to do this video many times today and finally got something I think is decent. This tool here allows you to make some really good audio edits. So let's make things a little bigger so you can see them. And you might notice these little zaggies in our waveform here. That's actual noise. So whenever you're recording anything, always give yourself some dead space, some silent time, that is, so you can record that noise. So what we'll do is we'll highlight that with this little I-beam tool. Go to our effect, go to noise removal, generate the noise profile, then we'll simply deselect it, go back to effect, and where is it? Noise removal. And we'll just take all the defaults here and hit the little OK, and it will take all of the noise out of our video. Now there's little peaks in our thing. That might be some gum smacking or heavy breathing or whatnot. Just go to the effect, go to amplify, and just cut that down by, I don't know, minus 12 dB, and that will make that go away. You can also spice up your video or your audio a little bit by going to equalizer and brightening up your voice with the highs and maybe taking some of the rumble out by decreasing some of the lows with this little equalization tool. Then once that is done, you might want to run the normalize on it just to get everything to somewhat of a consistent level. Now if I play that, let's see. Sweating copper pipes is easy. Here's how. First, cut the pipe. Good clean audio and ready for insertion into our project. So we already have a narration track down here. So what I need to do is just simply export this audio on top of the existing WAV file. Yeah, let it override it and all that good, good stuff. And we'll add that narration track into Premiere Elements. Actually, it didn't add it. It just updated what was there. So if I play this thing, sweating copper pipes is easy. Here's how. I've got some really good clean audio first with my project. So that's the first step, the narration. What a lot of people like to do is add some background music. Probably a no-brainer at this point, but there is a soundtrack track that you can add an asset to. So I think I'll go ahead and add this background music here. Good enough. You may not like it. It may not be the best, but this is just an example here on adding and manipulating tracks. Now, obviously, this thing came in way, way too loud. Can't even hear me speak when this background track is going. Sweating copper pipes is easy. There's a couple things that you can do. You can, let me make this bigger so you can see it. You can just grab that little yellow bar right there, which is the volume, and drag that down to an appropriate level. Here's how. And you know, to get it to the spot where you want it, or you can go in here and add these little keyframes here. So at the very beginning, we'll add a keyframe. Then when I start talking, add another keyframe. And then you can change that audio at a point in time. So now you can see the music start off loud and then get gradually quieter. Sweating copper pipes is easy. Here's how. There's another way to do it, and I've just started to experiment with this thing. I'm not a professional with it yet, but I'm starting to get used to it, and that is something called the audio mixer. Before you get into this thing, you might want to go over to your edit preferences and go to your audio, and then right here on the audio section where it says minimum time interval thinning, you might want to change that to 1,000 milliseconds or 1 second. By default, it's like 20 or something. So whenever you're changing the values, get a million little key points in your waveform down here. It's very, very hard to edit. So change that to 1,000. I'll show you what this looks like in just a second. So let's bring up our little audio mixer and we'll go ahead and play this thing. So you'll notice the volume levels on the soundtrack will go down because it's going to follow that waveform or that volume settings. Sweating copper pipes is easy. Here's how. Now if you want to crank it up. First, cut the pipes to length using a hacksaw or pipe cutter. Cut it back down. Make sure to cut the pipe length longer before insertion into the fitting. Crank it back up. And let it play until I start talking again. Then you can just gradually cut it back down to whatever you want. So when you stop your video, next, you got to get your pipe. Notice how it puts all these little keyframes in your For You automatically. Now that setting that I just showed you, that 1,000 for the interval, if you would have left that to the default, you would have had a couple of hundred little nodes in here, these little keyframes. It's very, very difficult to edit, but with just a few of them in there, I can pull and tug these things around and move them kind of wherever I want to get the right volume levels. Kind of a fun way to edit this. If you don't want them, you can always go to the next keyframe or whatever, hit the keyframe button again and it will delete these out. Or you can always right mouse button on it and hit the delete that way. So that's just one way that you can control the volume. Actually, there's a couple ways that you can control the volume of your soundtrack. Some things that you may have heard on TV that when you're watching like an auto mechanic show or This Old House or whatever, they've got a period of dead space in their narration when the person actually isn't doing anything or saying anything, but they're actually doing something. So let's go ahead and put some more background music in here. Now, if you ever run out of audio tracks or even video tracks, you can always add more. With this track expanded, right-click in here and go to the Add Tracks, and you can add as many audio and video tracks as you want. There's probably a limit there. I don't know what it is. All right, so at this point in time, let's go ahead and add another soundtrack, and I have no idea what this is, but it sounds pretty cool. So let's go ahead and add that to our track. Also, notice to our audio 2 track, that is. Notice how if I expand my narration, I can really see when the talking stops and when it starts. I can sort of position my video. Sorry, I keep calling these things videos, and I don't know why. My audio right between there. Now, you know the process. I want this thing to gradually turn on, so let's get to the very beginning of that. Just hit page up. If you didn't know that, page up, page down gets to the next endpoints of any of your tracks. We'll go ahead and add a couple keyframes here. And I will drag this very beginning down so nothing happens. And then somewhere around here, I'll add another keyframe so it goes down to that level goes down to a nothing. Now, I could have done that with this this audio mixer. So let me actually show that at the same time when I'm playing through this thing. You can watch the levels go up and down. It's kind of fun to watch. Axon or pipe cutter. Make sure now that soundtrack is probably a little bit too high, but you can see it coming down here. The audio 2 increases. I'm not talking, so it's kind of a neat way to control that. Next, then it goes back down to nothing, and then I start talking sandpaper again. So if you want to move things around, you can always kind of grab these little handles, keyframes, and move them. Actually, I think that was a little bit loud earlier. A little bit better control there. And of course, what we showed earlier on this soundtrack, this was all way too loud in here, so we can cut all that down just by dragging these things to kind of wherever we want. All right, so there's a couple things that you might run into, and every once in a while I run into it that after I record a narration, I don't hear anything, and there's some volume that gets set inappropriately. I don't know what. If you ever run into that, just grab your narration track and drag it up to another available audio track, and that seems to clean up that that problem. All right, so if we play this thing here, and I'm going to try to not talk and let you watch.
Sweating copper pipes is easy. Here's how. First, cut the pipes to length using a hacksaw or pipe cutter. Make sure to cut the pipe length longer for insertion into the fitting. Next, you gotta...
All right, so that's it in a nutshell. A couple things we did, we used this neat tool called this narration tool to record a track, a narration track, and that allows me to watch the video at the same time. Depending on how good you are, you might not be able to keep up in your speaking and keep it aligned with the video, so you might have to write a script like what I did. And I also showed how to add soundtracks, other little audio tracks, and control the volume using this neat little tool called this audio mixer. So it depends on you if you like to use these things, but I found sometimes they're very, very valuable. Another tool that I showed, my personal favorite here is Audacity, a great tool for cleaning up your audio, getting rid of noise and any kind of popping sounds. I can't believe Audacity is free. I don't know how they make any money, but great, go download it and use it today. That's it for getting the most out of sound with Adobe Premiere Elements. Thanks for watching.